Hey guys, to set up our notes area, let's first check out our API. And the first thing we're going to want to do is the get. So I'll scroll down a little ways, and you see we have this get to do guy here. Let me just copy him up like so. And let's make sure, move it down to the get note. Okay, we can get rid of one of these require logins. This session user ID isn't needed here. So with this, we're going to use the note model. And we'll just change this to note ID, note ID, note ID. Okay. Now, we did have a little string up here that we didn't need, and that was in the to do, get to do, right here, this guy. I'll just delete him. And we could actually open our navigator if you'd like, window navigation navigator. And this can help a great deal. Should have had it open a while ago. So we're going to get note. Let's make sure this looks right. Note model, note model. And remember, we instantiated this in the construct. If I go up here, it's right here. So back to get note, okay? And what we'll do is insert some fake data in the note. Our user ID is 1 if you logged in under admin, admin. And I'll just press insert. I'll put 1. The title will be test and hello. Okay, I'll shrink that guy down. And I don't know yet if we have an API call going for the note. So let's go to our views, dashboard, dashboard view, and we have our create note, our list note. Okay, there's our list notes. Now let's go to our JavaScript. Public, JS, junior dash, and let's go to dashboard. So we have load to do. Let's type out what we're gonna do for load note. And I wanna type it out with you so that you get the feel of it. So we're doing a get, and a get is basically just a HTTP call. So I'll say slash API, get note function, and the little O in here is the callback or the JSON response. Okay, and I want to make sure this is JSON. And in here, I'll start with my var output is just going to be an empty string. Now, it's not good to just say var output sometimes because it will come back as undefined and it'll show up in your text. So let's say var for var I is 0, I is less than o.length, I plus plus. Just a simple for loop. And we'll do output plus equals template. Now let's go to our templates. We have our to-do here, and we have our note here. Okay. And we pass in an object in there. So, template.note OI. If it makes it any easier for you, whoops, make sure you don't have that comma there. You could call this OBJ for object, so that it helps you, because really what this is a JSON object, because we're doing a get and returning JSON from the server. I do this quite a bit, so I just like things to be short. And what we're gonna do is populate that list, which was called list underscore note. List underscore note dot HTML will be output, okay? So go ahead and pause your video if you need to, or if you really didn't want to type it, you would just copy paste this and see if it works. So back here, I'll refresh. And we had get to do called, but we didn't have get note called. So I'll go back to the top and I'll say load note. Okay. And refresh. So get note was called, and there was an error, undefined variable ID. Now it looks like we did get some stuff here. So let's go ahead and look at controllers API line 190. And 190, well, it looks like we have no ID in here. And let's see what we're doing for the get to do. Get to do has ID of null. Get note, we'll just do the same thing so we don't have to rethink a whole bunch. Okay. And there is test hello. Cool. And this is going to be pretty straightforward. We're going to pimp this out quite a bit. Let's go ahead and get a create. I'll go ahead and copy all this junk in the to-do. So I'm under create to-do. I'm copying all this code. Now I'm going to go to, let's see, get note. I want to do create note. Okay. And paste. And we only need one of these. So when we create a note, what do we have? Let's take a look. We have a title, and the name of this is title. And we have a text area, and the name is content. So we have title and content. So we're going to need two rules. I'll go ahead and control shift down arrow to duplicate that. I'll change this to title. Title. I'll go to the end of this line, and I'm going to say the max length to this is just going to be 50. The max length for the content, I don't know yet. Let's think about that. Content, let's make sure it's a text field. Content right here. And it is a text field. If it was a var character field, it would be limited to 255. So let's give it 500. If you're feeling generous later, you could improve it. And for the note model, in this one, we're going to pass the title. Don't forget to change your post. Remember, this is just form validation because we don't want them to be sneaky. And title, content, user ID, okay? And let me just do that. And we will try to create. Now, I'm not sure the DOM is quite yet working, so you see it went to that hash sign. So let's go ahead and go to the dashboard JS. Okay, and this will be under an event. So create note. Let's look at create to do. And I'm just going to copy this because it's starting to get to be a lot to type. Okay. And I'll go to create note. And you see this pound create note, that's what we're going to replace it with. See, when we name things all consistently, it's really, really helpful. What we have to change is the output template will be note, list will be note, and hopefully I didn't miss anything. I'll go ahead and refresh and see what happens for fun. Test and test. And it says test there, but it didn't insert it live into our DOM. Let's check our database and see what happened. Refresh, and it did insert right there. The question is, where is it on here? So I'll say, hey, create. For some reason, it says test up there. We'll fix all this in a bit. So it is creating successfully if I look at this. What I want to do is make sure our get is correct. So let's go back to the template and then get. Okay, the way to see is we can open our network tab. Let's see, get note. Note ID 1. Let me refresh. Get note. It looks like it's only getting one note. And let's look at the headers that were passed. We want, was it a get? Looks like we weren't passing anything. We were just passing get note. So we're going to have to take a look at the API of get note. And this says if ID is not equal to null, get where the note ID equals ID. Otherwise, get the note Oh, so sorry. This has to be user ID. Big typo. So make sure this is user ID. That was just getting note ID 1. So if I refresh, here are our notes. Let's try it once more. Hey, hey, create. And at the moment, we have to refresh, which we'll fix. And it's right there. Okay, so that'll wrap it up for the notes of just listing and creating. Okay, guys, now what we're going to try to do is just delete our notes. Let me move my window over. The reason is, well, I suppose we could edit them. You might want to. So let's do this. Let's add the check or something. We'll just edit it and the X will delete it. So first things first is we need to go to our template. And I'm going to close or shrink this window over. Okay. So the to-do has a complete state, but notes don't really have a complete state. They're just going to be notes. And it looks like I think we'll just use icon OK. So I'll copy that. And down here, I'll just make another line. And I'll just paste icon OK. And let's see where the delete is. Let me copy that. And I'll paste it there. Okay, so I just copied the to-do and I just gotta change this to note ID, change this to note delete, and this href will have to be delete note. Now, it looks like I didn't get the whole gist of the edit going on, so I'm just gonna copy this guy here. And instead of this line, we'll say boom. And this is going to be note update. Data ID will be note ID. And let's see, data completed. We don't need that. Href. We're actually not going to use this just yet because edit. Let me move this on my screen so hopefully you can see it all. Okay. So for the edit, it's note update. And we just have the note ID there. It's not going to go anywhere because it's actually got to display an edit form. So I'm going to change this to note edit. No, let's just leave it to note up. I don't like inconsistency, so I'll change it to note update display. It's only going to display the little form for us. Where is it? There we go. So this will delete and this will edit. Okay. So the first thing is, before I forget, I want to make sure this has an action, the note update display. So let's open our events.js file. And I'm going to make a new function and call this update note display because it's kind of like two steps. Let me slide this bar over. And update note, let's do one and call this var update note display equals function. Okay, and this is going to be our trigger. So that was a class, so when that class is clicked, we're going to get the data ID. So dot no update display dot click function e, and we'll say e dot prevent default so it doesn't try to go to a link, and I'll say node ID equals this dot data ID. Okay, and what we're actually going to want to do is make a template form. So let's go to our template.js. And here I will say this.note edit equals function. Let's give it an object parameter. Var output equals return output. Okay. And this doesn't look tabbed over totally. I guess it is. Okay, so what we want is there's a lot of things we could do, honestly. Let's first make a cancel button. So ahref equals nothing. Ahref goes nowhere. Class equals note edit cancel. Okay, and let's make another one, and we'll call this save. And we'll put these in little output variables. We're going to want a text area, and we're going to want an input type equals text. Name will be name. Name will be title, and text area will be name equals content. Okay, now I have the option to make this a form, and my question is, do I want to do that? And that's something I have to think about. So let's go back a second. I know this code isn't right there. We're going to load the template. So let's say template.noteEdit. Note ID. We're not going to pass an object in, we'll just pass in the note ID. I'll say var output. And we are going to place this. Let's see. If we look at our template code, let's give it a little spot right down here. We'll say output plus equals div. Class equals note edit container. Okay, so the note edit container is where we're going to place it. Okay, this will update the note display. Let me make this a var. And then for this guy here, we'll say output plus equals, add this to each one of these lines. Boom, 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 boom. Okay. And this is actually just going to be the note ID here. Okay. And what I want to do is, I think I'm going to wrap this in a form. I think it'll be easier. I'll put plus equals, and I'll say form method equals post, action equals, we'll get to that, and yeah, that'll be good. And then let's make our closing form tag, like that. And instead of this being an anchor tag, let's do it a submit button. So I'll say input type equals submit, and we'll get rid of this and just say value equals save. I know this is might be kind of difficult if you're not fluent in JavaScript, but maybe it'll help if you pause the video and kind of think about what's happening here. I'll duplicate this and just cut that. I can get rid of the class on the submit. And this value will be cancel. This one will be save. Okay, so for the action, if I recall, I believe it's API. Where did we put those? Those are under the dashboard. API get to do. this will be API slash, I believe it was update to do, but let's be sure in the API PHP update note. So our first goal is to have the form display when something happens. And I haven't thoroughly gone through all the steps, so our click isn't doing anything. So let's make sure. I'll inspect this and note update display. And in the event.js, let's make sure it's getting called at the top. Note update note display here. And this is actually going to have to be live, if I'm not mistaken. And to make sure it's getting called. People hate when I do this, but it's just the laziest man's way to do it is an alert. They always tell me to console log, but hey, I just want the alerts. So we got one and nothing else. No method live. Oops. We must be in a later version of jQuery. So let's check our, let's look for dot on, body dot on click to do update. So we'll change this to body dot on click like that. The newer jQuery uses on, so hopefully this will behave. Edit, we get an alert of 2 and it displays everything there, which we don't want at all. Let's make sure we get that right. So this goes to the no edit container, and in our template, let's look at the container right here, and I think we could just give this an ID and make our lives a lot easier. Div ID will be no edit container underscore plus plus object dot note ID. Okay. That has to be ID. And when we target this, we're going to target the noEdit container plus noteID. Okay. And let's go ahead and see what happens. Edit, cool. And then for the cancel, noteCancel, we'll say, right in the same method, we'll say body.onClick noteEditCancel function e.preventDefault. And we're going to say this.parentsDiv.html to nothing. Because we're dynamically adding, and then we want to dynamically remove, not just show and hide. So edit, cancel, and that removed everything. Did I type that wrong? Div.parent? So let me see if I got that right. Cancel. What is the parent name in the template? The parent name is... I see. So let me give this a class equals note edit container, and we'll just parent dot note edit container. Okay, let's try again. And edit cancel. Okay, that works. And before this video gets too long, we're gonna have to split this up into a couple of videos. But this gets the editing form ready. Welcome back, you guys. We're going to update the note, and this part's the hard part. So here's our page when we're logged in. We have the edit, cancel works, and save actually submits a form. So there's a couple things we have to do. And one of them is I don't want to display the content here. So if I type about me and say this is my story and create it, and I refresh the page, it should have displayed, there it is, about me, this is my story. I feel like this should be clickable and then it displays the content below it. So first, let's do that. I'll go to my template and I have my little navigator open. It's Control and 7 to open it, or window navigating navigator. And I'll just go down to my note edit. Okay, so, we want to go to note, I apologize, and just delete this content line here. So I'll just go ahead and delete. Okay, and for the title, I'm just going to make this an anchor tag, like that, and we'll get to that eventually. So if I go back here, I'll refresh, and now it's just my anchor tag. And it would display something. One thing I should do is just add a space here so the edit button's not right next to it. Next, let's get to work on posting this form. So here's our form, and we need to give it a class. So I'll call this class equals note edit form. I'll just copy that. And in our event, we have update note. So let's go to update note and I'll just paste that in there. And we're really just going to use one of these live events. So I'll paste that guy there and I'll change the class here. And make sure you have your period before there. Okay. And we're going to do a dot post. It's going to post to a URL with post data and a callback and JSON. Just a reminder, what's happening is we post a URL. This will be data in object form. And this is our callback after it's done processing. And the O inside here gets passed into this closure. And O represents the JSON data. And I have JSON there, so that's what I received back. So that jQuery knows to treat it as a JSON object. I will say that you can also type post JSON like that. That was in earlier versions. I don't recollect if it's still available. I think it is. I still prefer to do this way, but if you do it that way, you won't forget to put this JSON string down here. So I'll just say if o.result equals 1. Same thing we do every time. And we'll just say error saving result.success. And we'll say successfully updated note. Okay. Now there is no URL or post data at this moment. So let's see how we want to do this. First, I'm going to check and make sure that when I edit a form, it does not change the page. If it's not changing the page, then you're good. So we need the URL, and the URL is actually in the form. If we look at this, it's under action right here. That's the URL. And it's just easier to get the action from the attribute selector. So what I'll say is var URL equals this attribute action, okay, and the post data, it's going to be serialized data, or we could select individual data. There's a benefit to it in the fact that we can do it in one shot. It'll just collect all the data we need. In this case, we only have two items, so it's not a big deal. We're going to have to add a third item, though, and that's going to be the note ID. So go ahead and duplicate your line. I press Control Shift down just to remind you. We'll make this hidden. The name will be note ID, and the value
will be, whoops, note ID. Okay. I'm going to give these classes right here. I'm going to give this a class of title. And I'm going to give this text area a class of content. And you might be wondering, well, why are you going to do that? The reason is, if I'm inside of the form scope and you imagine everything's tabbed over, I have my object here and I want to select my title. It's just easier to do it with a class. So I'll show you what I mean. So I'll say this.find.title. Okay, that's a lot easier than saying this.findInputName equals title. It's just a little shorter. So I'll say var title, and we want to make sure we have all the goods. So I'll go ahead and console log title. If I know I can get it this way, I know I can get all the other stuff. We also don't want to forget this guy. Class equals note ID. Now I'm going to provide this code at the end of the series because you might get this wrong and it's a little complicated, and I know it's hard to see a little bit on my screen. I can only fit so much code here so that it's readable. So hopefully this is enough to follow. So I'll refresh, edit, and DD. Oops, I did that on an on-click event. It needs to be submit. So let me just fix that one moment. body on submit, not click. Edit. Okay, so let's see what it found. Input.title. That's not what we wanted. So let's go ahead and do dot val, because we want to get the form value. So I'll duplicate this. Actually, let's make our post data variable now. I'll say var post data equals an object, and I'll say title will be this guy. And we'll say content, change this to content, and once, I guess at the top, let's put a note ID. Remember how we gave these class names? Okay, so post data, and then that will post there. So let's give it a whirl, make sure there's no errors in our console. Test, save, and check our network tab. Update note, I have my XHR selected down here so that I don't see all of this junk. So update note, and let's see what we posted. Note ID 5, title test, content test. Cool. So let's build a response in PHP. This will be quite easy. Let's open up our API. And let's go to update to do, because we'll just copy the code from here. Now we don't have to retype it. Sometimes it's really good to retype your code though, but we'll do it this way for now. This will be called note ID. Okay. So note ID. And let's see, what do we got here? You know, there's another way we could do this. Let's just cut this input post. And I'll go ahead and delete this, and I'll say content title. And we'll say title is that. Content is there. We need to change this to our note model. And you see my little red arrow? I forgot my comma. Okay. And I'll put note ID in there. So, result equals note model update title title, content, content with the note ID. If the result is successful, it will have an affected row. So let's go ahead and refresh the page. Edit, I'll say test, test, save. And it updated the note. Now you notice nothing changed yet, so let me hit cancel and I'll go ahead and refresh. And there it is, test. Let's try it with 123 and 123. Refresh. There it is there. So one thing we want to do is change this DOM instantly. To do so, in our event, we're going to want to use the post data dot title. Okay, and this is what we're going to populate the new template section with. So let's look for note. So we have a div ID of note underscore object note ID. I'm just going to give this guy a new ID and I'll say note title underscore object note ID. Now we could get into traversing like we did with this class, how we had the form, then we did find class title. And this may seem inconsistent, but we'll mix it up a little bit and you decide what you like best. I will say that ID lookups are a lot faster because it's native in ECMAScript 3, which is, I think that's the latest. So, boom, boom, plus, plus. Oh, already had that. Object.noteID. So we're going to look for the note title with the note ID. So I'll say note title plus postdata.noteid.html. And we're just going to put in this post.title. I'll move this under the result success like that. And hopefully that updates that. So edit, test, and there it is there. That's exactly what we want. So cancel, edit, hey, let's make sure the content's saving. I'm gonna open up my database and go to my note table. And here's hey. So, whoops. I'll say jargon and fish fries. Save it up. And F5 to refresh, I have jargon and fish fries. So that did update nicely. Let's take a look at this. One thing else we're going to want to happen is when we click edit, we want the title to appear and the content to appear. So let's do this. Let's go to our template and we'll just make a output plus equals. We'll say div class equals hide. I don't know yet if we have that working. It's part of Bootstrap. It's hide or hidden. We'll find out. And in here, we're going to put object dot content. So let me refresh and let's see what happens. We'll look at jargon. And here it is, hide, fish fries, good. So if I look at this, this has a note title. Let's do a note content class ID. So I'll copy him, the title class, sorry, ID, and paste him right here. And I'm just gonna change this to note content.